Jennifer Lawrence is one of the biggest names in Hollywood.
Right here, Chad, right.
But overnight, the young Oscar winner took center stage for a different reason after dozens of nude and risque photos of the actress appeared on an anonymous online image sharing site. And with them, similar photos reporting to show supermodel Kate Upton, singers Rihanna and Ariana Grande, and more than 100 other famous women in what many call the biggest celebrity hacking ever.
The words common sense were the first thing spoken by many when news broke about various female celebrities' cloud accounts being hacked and their revealing photos and videos splashed around the viral world for all to see. After all, if you don't want something stolen, don't put it on a server somewhere in the world. But this is becoming a much more serious story with a bend toward possible child porn and more than a few laws being broken. It is the seamy side of Hollywood and the Internet. Welcome to Midpoint, a Newsmax insider and author of the Left Coast Report, author James Hirsen, and a former cybercrime chief for the FBI, now CEO of the Larson Security firm, Scott Larson. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us today.
Great to be with you.
All right, I'll tell you what, I'm going to start out on the Left Coast here. James, honestly, let's start the discussion right here before we get into the legalese. Common sense. If you don't want things like this found, don't put them up where somebody can steal them. That seems to be what a lot of people are saying right off the bat.
Oh, absolutely. We're in a post-privacy world, and people who are celebrities, it is foreseeable that they're going to go after your pictures and your emails and everything else. We're talking about a world in Hollywood of paparazzi, and these are just digital paparazzi. There's big bucks in getting those pictures, and there's other motivations, the similar motivations to the paparazzi, and the agents, the entertainment lawyers, the managers, should be now using this as a learning experience and instructing, particularly these young female celebrities, number one, not to take nude selfies with a cell phone and not to take them at all, ideally. And number two, anything that you put up in what we're now calling the cloud is there forever.
Well, if you're going to take them, you can keep things private. I don't know about you, but I seem to remember that whether you have a digital camera on your phone or somewhere else, you have the ability to take a picture. You then can download it, you can upload it, put it someplace else. You can erase what's there. You don't have to put things up in a cloud somewhere, which, by the way, a British newspaper actually put out a line. They said the cloud is not actually a cloud. Some people actually thought that's what it was. But wouldn't that at least just make the common sense right there, at least, that you're going to get, and certainly as celebrities, I think you brought this out as well, they're targets to begin with. Everything they do is money for somebody else somewhere down the line, correct?
No, that is correct. And also celebrities are not tech experts. They have an entourage, and now I think they're going to have tech experts because a lot of them fell for phishing with a PH, this kind of fake email that gets your, reportedly, that's how they got in. And they had these really naive passwords. Reportedly, Jennifer Lawrence had a password, hunger. So they have to learn to, what you said, they don't understand preferences and options. And so I'm afraid that what happened, we'll find out, is that they had a default position in their smartphone where all these selfies that perhaps some of them thought were private were automatically uploaded to their account in the cloud.
Well, Scott, that's apparently what happened here, because they're saying that it wasn't a problem with the Apple iCloud system. It was a gang of hackers who collected and traded nude pictures of female celebrities. They were breaking into accounts simply by guessing passwords, by going back and forth so many times. And now, of course, we have what's called spear phishing that has walked into this. If you would please just give us an idea of how easy it is for somebody to get into any email anywhere if you don't take precautions. And what is spear phishing?
It's trivial to get in people's passwords if they do not take the precautions. Spear phishing is targeted email, where if I want to target, let's say, a celebrity, I want to first try to learn their background, who their friends are, and send an email, act like it's coming from one of their friends or family, and say very common things like happy birthday or look at this photo, and cause that person to click. Once you click, you open your system up to potentially some malicious software being run, your computer being accessed, and then from there, whether it's a backup, the backup of the smartphone, or getting into the cloud services, it's rather simplistic.
But here's another thing too, apparently, and this is according to a guy named Chris Cheney. He's 36 years old, Jacksonville, Florida. He got 10 years in prison for hacking into the email accounts of 50 celebrities or people in the entertainment industry. He admitted all he did was took their email address, clicked on forgot your password, went around the internet, read everything he could about them, and then just started picking out random words to throw in there as a new password, and he got it set just like that. Honestly, I gotta be serious with you. How stupid can people be, Scott?
Well, that is a successful technique. You know, Sarah Palin had that happen to her as well. And that's with Facebook, all the public information with people on your, you know, what is your mother's maiden name, for example, and getting back in. Now, one thing people should do is they should try and use two-step verification, which is, you know, Google Gmail has it, for example, where you try to log in, you use your login ID and password, but then it texts you a six-digit PIN, and then you put it in for that instance. Now, people that are very, high net worth CEOs and celebrities don't like that, cumbersome generally, but they're going to have to change.
Well, it's another step they have to take. Of course, you don't want people to have to think to do something to protect their security, do you, Scott? I mean, that would be just absolutely ridiculous here. I do need to ask you this. As a former cybercrime chief in the FBI, there's now discussion that some of the pictures that were stolen were of young ladies underage, which now brings another entirely new series of thoughts into this, that now it's considered porn by many people here as it goes around the internet. Is the FBI, in your opinion, proper in getting involved in this? And does this open up a large investigation that really is going to go very far afield from here and might affect a lot of people across America?
It certainly could. There is a whole Crimes Against Children task force and initiative within the FBI. In this particular case, it depends on how old the individual is and whether it's consent. You know, if it's amongst boyfriend, girlfriend, I think that's looked at in a little different light. But once somebody steals it and distributes it, you're distributing child pornography, and also just having possession of it is a crime, much like having cocaine or some other illegal drug is a crime. Possessing child porn is a crime in and of itself.
Is this something that we're going to see the FBI get more involved in, not only because it's celebrities, but are we now looking at a widening net for people who steal little things, not just celebrities, but now digging into this a lot more, spending a lot more money and time because this is unfortunately the wave of the future?
It is the wave of the future, and they're going to spend a lot of time on it. And this isn't the first time that they've worked these types of cases. And it could have been, you know, Madonna had some photos before. There's a lot of high-profile cases. And this, as the previous speaker said, this is worth money. And the FBI or, you know, local law enforcement will get involved and try and prosecute them. And they'll probably choose or use whatever statute they can to try and bring them to justice.
James, do you think this is really going to change anything in Hollywood? I mean, let's face it, we all look at Hollywood as a very different animal. As has already been pointed out here, these aren't the sharpest tools in the shed in many ways when it comes to actors, actresses, entertainers. They don't understand most of the things in life. So is this really going to make any difference, or are we still going to see people just playing and throwing it up on the internet no matter what?
I think the sheer size of it and the publicity and all the discussion will have some effect, and particularly among, as I mentioned, the handlers of celebrities, the agents, the managers, the lawyers are going to be advising their celebrities. They're going to bring in tech consultants. But, you know, these people are victims. So I expect that the attempt to find these people and to prosecute them, you know, the previous speaker talked about the statutes. There's some pretty severe penalties for these statutes, and there's multiple counts because there's so many computers that were hacked and so many victims. We're talking about hundreds of years of potential jail time if they find these hackers, and that may change the other side of the equation. Maybe we'll have people think twice about cavalier hacking of celebrities.
And cavalier putting things up on a cloud that you can basically get anywheres. Hey, Scott, I needed to ask you one last thing about 30, 40 seconds I have left here. James just mentioned hundreds of years of possible jail time here, but that's if you can find them, because isn't it fair to say a lot of these people are China, Russia, Lithuania, Africa, other places? You can't find these people a lot of times.
You know, that's true, but usually somebody, you follow the money, and somebody's going to pay for it, and then you work backwards from there. and there's probably some nexus to the United States or somebody who's really going to profit from this. So people have been apprehended all around the world. It obviously is more difficult if it's in China or Russia, but people do get arrested around the world and brought either to the United States or serve time in their host country.
Would either one of you like to give me your password for your email while we're here?
Easy answer, no.
Easy answer, I like that very much. Would that other people could understand no as well. Scott Larson, James Hirsen, thanks so much for joining us today, gentlemen. We appreciate it.
All right, thank you.
All right, later on this hour, News Call digs into those who decide a terrorist life is for them, no matter who dies along the way. And after the break, why investigators are in no hurry to recover a stolen diamond ring. It's all about a trip to Outland.